From the beginning, God created humanity to worship and fellowship with him. However, in an evil attempt to destroy the intimate relationship between God and humanity, Satan devised a scheme to deceive and lead them into sin, thereby bringing separation. But God had a greater plan, a plan of ultimate sacrifice which would redeem humanity and restore the broken relationship. This is the story of that plan. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin betrothed to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said unto her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asks the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One will come to be born, will be called the Son of God." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May it be unto me as you have said." Then the angel left her. Joseph, her husband, being a righteous man, did not want to expose her to public disgrace. So he had in his mind to put her away privately. But after he had considered, the Holy Spirit, she, Mary, would give birth to a son. And the angel said that you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All of this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel. A decree came out from Caesar Augustus that a census should be taken and everyone should return to his own town to register. Before Joseph, because he was from the line of David, he took Mary and journeyed to Bethlehem, the town of David. And while they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And Mary gave birth to a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord was shining all around them. And the shepherds, they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today in the city of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to humanity on whom his favor rests."
Oh,
The long-awaited hope, the promised Messiah, came to earth with a purpose. His purpose was to bring healing to the broken, freedom to the captive, and salvation to the lost. Jesus Christ came to earth in human form as God's answer for restoration between himself and a fallen human race. He was born in a stable, and from that stable, he would change the course of the world. The scriptures tell us that Jesus grew in wisdom and in stature. Even as a child, he would stir the temple goers to marvel at what he said. As his ministry began, he taught the crowds, he fed the multitudes, he healed the sick, and he raised the dead. Truly, Jesus Christ, God made man, by his very presence on earth, changed history and provided hope to humanity. So let us now rejoice and celebrate the incarnation of God's promise.
Come to earth through an ordinary virgin girl.
Jesus declared that if we did not praise him, the rocks would cry out in our place. So tonight we express our praise to God in purity and in truth. We declare that we will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in our mouths. Join with us in expression of praise to Jehovah.
And when he grew older, and the Spirit like a dove rested on his shoulder, he met fishes and men down by the sea.
Hallelujah, praise Jehovah.
He healed the sick and set the captives free.
Hallelujah, praise the Lord.
I said, come on, come on.
Indeed, the life and ministry of Jesus here on earth made a profound impact in the lives of the multitudes that he reached. However, a lifetime on earth would not have been enough alone. It would take a greater sacrifice to bring healing to this depraved world. It would take the very life of the promised one. Jesus willingly laid down his life in order to bring reconciliation between God and humanity. And in so doing, he reclaimed the relationship that Satan had once taken. Jesus took upon himself the sins and the ills of the world in order to bring wholeness to those who would surrender to him and accept his sacrifice as the gift he intended it to be. And because of this, we no longer have to walk in darkness. We are not required to live in sin. We no longer have to accept the emptiness and the void that was created at the very point of separation from God. We now have a bridge, and his name is Jesus. And when we surrender to him and accept his forgiveness, we again have free access to the throne of God, and thereby allowing us to experience an intimate relationship with our Creator and our Father. worship God with songs of praise to commemorate the birth of our Savior. Many of those songs are recognized as sounds of the holiday season. Let's join together tonight in singing some of these melodies, some old, some new, the songs that lift up and glorify Christ our King.
Bye.
When his work on earth was complete, Jesus ascended into heaven, where he now sits at the right hand of God the Father. The scriptures tell us that around the throne of God there are beings who eternally cry out to him, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." When those beings cry out, giving glory and honor and thanks unto God, the 24 elders seated around the throne fall down before him, saying, "You are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you have created all things, and for your pleasure they were created." These beings were created with the sole purpose of worshiping God. However, we have the ability to choose whether we want to worship God or do not. The thankfulness and the gratitude from our hearts overflow tonight as we reflect on the profound gift God provided us in the birth, in the death, and the resurrection of his Son, our Savior, Jesus. We have a choice, and tonight we choose to worship our awesome and holy God with deep passion and with reverence.
Lord, your holy, Lord, the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great sorrow, of famine and darkness and sword, still we are the voice in the desert crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. The dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David rebuilding the temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, for the fields are wide in this world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word.
There's no one like you, Jesus. There's no one like you.